वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज शफीक अहमद एंड यू आर ऑल वेलकम टू योर फेवरेट यूट्यूब चैनल लेट्स लर्न टुगेदर।
सो अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन आवर प्रीवियस ट्यूटोरियल दैट अबाउट हिटलर्स डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी, हाउ ही डिस्ट्रॉयड द डेमोक्रेसी इन जर्मनी, है ना, दैट वी हैव टू सी, वी हैव डिस्कस्ड ऑल्सो। सो लेट मी On 30th January 1933, Hitler accepted the offer of chancellorship which he was looking for. So he got the opportunity from the president Hindenburg. So that is very important from the point of view of MCQ, that who gave the offer to Hitler to become the chancellor of Germany. So you must remember the name, President Hindenburg has given the opportunity to him. So after what? After that, he just started fire decree on 20th February 1933, and indefinitely he suspended all the civic rights. है ना, सारे civic rights को उसने क्या कर दिया? Suspend कर दिया. And like freedom of speech, press, freedom of assembly, everything he just suspended. Because he has become the chancellor of Germany, so now no one can just take decisions above him. He was the only one person. And what he did next, he arrested and he killed those communists, especially socialists, democrats and Catholics. He suspended them, he arrested and even killed them also, because they were speaking against Hitler. So there were total 52 fire type of victims who were persecuted and prosecuted. These are the different words. Persecuted means they have been taken into the concentration camp without any procedure of law, yani bina koi court, bina koi case ka un logo ko wo le jate the aur arrest karke kill bhi karte the. They used to kill them also in the concentration camp. So on 3rd March 1933, enabling act, he passed enabling act also, which established dictatorship in Germany. Means Hitler sidelined all the parliament parties, other opposition parties. He just banned all the opposition parties and he started ruling by decree. Decree ko bhi maine discuss kiya tha, that it is such an official order or law, it can be an act also, which you cannot challenge, which the citizen of the country cannot challenge. They will have to accept it by hook or by crook. So political parties and trade unions all were banned except for the Nazi party and its branches. He established complete control over the economy, media, army, judiciary, and even you can see over here, he created special surveillance and security forces, which was controlling the order in the society of the society in which the Nazi wanted. Nazis aisa chahte the, usko implement karne ke liye Hitler has created special surveillance and security forces, which included Gestapo. Gestapo kya hai? Ek secret state police hai, yani ki ye secretly kaam karti hai. Means they will be in civil dress, they will be in your dress, है ना, वो local people के dress में रहेंगे और आपके साथ रहेंगे, आपके दोस्त बन के रहेंगे, and you would not knowing that they are the police, आपके friend बन के, and if you will see speak a single word against Hitler or his party, Nazi party, or if you are going to take any step against the Nazi party or Hitler, then you will be punished. They will know that he is the man who is trying to go against Hitler. So that Gestapo was a very dangerous one, because they were secretly working throughout Germany. And they have the SS protection squad also, criminal police, security services, apart from the police in green uniform and the stormtroopers. So aap dekh sakte kitne type ke police aur security forces hai unke paas, hai na, police in green uniform hai, stormtroopers hai, security services SD hai, criminal police hai, protection squad SS protection squad hai, aur Gestapo bhi hai, and special surveillance and security forces. इतने सारे फोर्सेस और इतने सारे लोग हैं विच आर प्रोटेक्टिंग हिटलर टू रूल लाइक अ डिक्टेटर. सो लेट अस कम टू आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ द टुडे, दैट इज क्वाइट डेंजरस माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, है ना, बी ब्रेव टू लिसन ऑल दिस थिंग्स, है ना, थोड़ा दिल को मजबूत कर लें ये सुनने के लिए कि उन्होंने क्या किया आफ्टर दैट. दैट इज जेनोसाइडल वॉर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस, अ वॉर विच इज गोइंग ऑन, विच गोज ऑन विद इन द कंट्री, जो कंट्री के अंदर ही होता है, दैट इज नोन एज द जेनोसाइडल वॉर. Germany had waged a genocidal war which resulted in the mass murder of the selected groups of innocent civilians of Europe. आप देख सकते हैं कि genocidal war में क्या हुआ है, mass murder, यानी mass means what? A huge number, है ना, बहुत ज्यादा लोगों का murder करना, of selected groups, और वो सेलेक्टेड ग्रुप्स कौन से हैं, कैथोलिक्स हैं, सोशलिस्ट लोग हैं और जो भी हिटलर के अगेंस्ट है, दे आर द सेलेक्टेड ग्रुप्स, स्पेशली द जीयूस। जीयूस जो है वो खास करके जो है वो सेलेक्टेड ग्रुप में आते हैं बिकॉज दे वर द मोस्ट इनिमी, यू कैन से सबसे बड़े दुश्मन जो हिटलर के थे वो जीयूस थे। So which resulted in the mass murder of selected groups of innocent civilians. Civilians का कोई कसूर नहीं था, वो गुनहगार नहीं थे, वो क्या थे, innocent थे, है ना, बेकसूर लोगों का भी बहुत सारा खून बहा दिया गया genocidal war में। The number of people killed included 6 million Jews. You can see my dear student, 6 million means 60 lakh. 60 lakh people, 60 lakh Jews were killed in this genocidal war. Genocidal war yani war within the country. Koi dusre country se ladai nahi ho rahi hai, apni country mein apne hi logon ka safaya kiya ja raha hai, that is the genocidal war. So 6 million Jews ko maar diya gaya, and later on I will tell you the reason why they were killing so many Jews, and there are few reasons. So they included 6 million Jews, 2 lakh gypsies, the people from the Egypt. Egypt में से जो लोग रहते थे जर्मनी में आकर, उनको भी नहीं छोड़ा गया. They have been also killed. 2 lakh gypsies were killed. Even 1 million means 10 lakh. 10 lakh police civilians, you know, people from the Poland. उसको कहते हैं Polish civilians. So Poland से रहने वाले भी लोग थे, 10 lakh लोग जर्मनी में रह रहे थे. Even they were also killed. और हद तो तब हो गया when they have killed 70,000 Germans also, यानी खुद के लोगों को भी मार दिया उन्होंने, they killed the pure Germans also because they consider that they are mentally and physically disabled, यानी के those Germans who were mentally weak और physically weak, they were thinking that they are the burden on the country, वो सोचते थे कि ये लोग जो है हमारे देश के ऊपर क्या है, बोझ हैं, तो इनको भी मार दिया जाए, so they have killed their person, their men also, 70,000 Germans were also killed, those who were mentally or physically disabled means handicap, यानी जिनका किसी का एक हाथ नहीं है, किसी का एक पैर अगर नहीं है, किसी का एक आंख नहीं है, those who were mentally handicapped, they have killed their persons also, 70,000 Germans were killed, you can see, and besides innumerable political opponents, or political opponents, यानी कि जो भी politically those who were against Hitler, they were also killed, and we don't have any number, है ना, how many of the political opponents were killed, because it is clearly written, my dear, that it is innumerable, यानी कि uncountable है, कितना लोगों को उन्होंने मारा है political opponents को, that is not countable, गिना नहीं जा सकता, so you can see here, the blood was everywhere, there was a complete bloodshed in Germany during the time of Hitler, because he was killing even his own person, even his own men also, those who were physically and mentally disabled, 2 lakh gypsies were killed, 1 million Polish and 6 million Jews, है ना, सबसे ज्यादा जो है Jews को मारा गया वहां पर। And Nazis devised an extraordinary means of killing people. तो उन लोगों ने कैसे मारा? How they have killed the people? They have implemented a new way, है ना? नया तरीका से उन्होंने मारा है लोगों को. Let us see. By gassing them in the various killing sectors, they used to gas them. They used to pack them in a gas chamber, and by after packing them in the inside the gas chamber, they used to just insert start a poisonous gas in the chamber, and due to which a lot of people can be killed in few minutes only. So one of the gas center, killing center, you know, that is known as Auschwitz. Auschwitz was the very famous and the biggest one. The gas killing center was there. So the men who were against, like Jews, gypsies, political opponents, they used to be sent to Auschwitz in the gas chamber, and there they used to kill them. But they were not using their bullets. They were saying that why should we waste our bullets? Let us kill them with the help of the gas, you know, poisonous gas. So you can just imagine, people used to die just with very, you can say, hard. That is quite destructive, and that is quite unimaginable. You cannot imagine that type of death also. So what do you mean by the word genocidal? That's killing on large scale leading to destruction of large section of people. Genocidal means what? Killing on large scale, which can lead to destruction of large section of people. So that is all in this topic over here. So as we have discussed earlier also, that the economy of Germany was quite weak, and it was going down and down, so people were helpless. So what Hitler did to reconstruct the Germany, to reconstruct the economy of Hitler? So as he was not a great economist, Hitler was not an economist, he was not an expert, so he can take the help of an expert. So he assigned Hjalmar Schacht, you know, that is the name of a great economist of that time. You know, ye Hjalmar Schacht jo hai, wo bahut achhe economist hai. See, you can see the image of this man. He was great economist. He can give suggestion to Hitler how to just strengthen your economy. So he provided employment. He suggested Hitler, let us provide employment to the people. So Hitler started giving employment to the people through a state-funded work creation program. Means the fund will be given by the country, the fund will be given by the state, and he started giving employment to the people, and he produced famous German superhighway. You can see, he started the construction of German superhighway. German superhighway ka bhi, superhighway ka creation bhi start ho gaya, construction bhi start ho gaya. Now people were getting jobs, and people's car, aur logon ke liye ek car bhi unhone introduce kiya. He said that this is the car for the people, the Volkswagen car, this is the car that he introduced. He was selling them at a lesser cost. Like in India, we got that nano car, huh, na? Within 1 lakh rupees, you can get that car, nano car. So likewise, Hitler also introduced this Volkswagen car, and he was saying, this is the car for you people. I have done this for you, that everyone now can walk in car, travel in car. And he acquired quick successes in foreign policies also. So, उन्होंने foreign policies में भी उनको काफी success मिला Hitler को, because Hjalmar Schacht was giving advice to the Hitler. He reoccupied Rhineland in 1936. And Hitler reoccupied Rhineland also in the year 1936, which was taken by France. You must have remembered that Treaty of Versailles. So Treaty of Versailles ke wajah se ye Rhineland unke haath mein se chala gaya tha. But now Hitler has occupied that once again. He integrated Austria in the year 1938, aur unhone Austria ko apne saath shamil kar liya tha. He included Austria with Germany, means he just extended his boundaries, and he included Austria in the year 1938 by giving one slogan. Ye ek slogan bata kar unhone Austria ko apne saath kar liya. Kya slogan diya tha unhone? One people, one empire, and there should be one leader. Hai na, ek aadmi leke sabhi, means all the Germans are one, and they need only one empire, and they need also only one leader also. So he was giving the slogan to the Austrian also, that why do you need another leader, why do you need another empire, let us come together and let us live together. So he integrated Austria, one people, one empire, and one leader, by giving this slogan also. He snatched ka matlab chhin liya. Unhone kya chhin liya? German speaking Sudetenland from Czechoslovakia. Czechoslovakia se Sudetenland ko unhone chhin liya, because in Sudetenland most of the people were speaking German language. So he snatched that country also, Sudetenland also, from Czechoslovakia, and he took control over the entire country, and he got unspoken support of England also. Aur England bhi jo hai kiska madad kar raha tha? Hitler ka. Hitler was getting help of England also, but that was unspoken. Yani ki wo officially help nahi kar rahe the, but they were England was helping Hitler, or you can say Germany unofficially. So he was just, Hitler was having full control over the entire country. And you can see that is that may be one of the mistake of Hitler also, that he invested hugely on rearmament. Even the state was running out of deficit financing. Hitler invested a lot of amount on rearmament, that is procuring or purchasing new weapons for the fight, for the war. Kyunki Hitler ke dimag mein ye tha ki mujhe ek aur jang ladna hai. I have to do one war once again, or I have to occupy and conquer the whole world. He means at least he wanted to conquer the whole Europe. Wo pure Europe pe raj karna chahte the. So he was maintaining huge army also, and he was, you can see, he was purchasing and spending a lot of money on the weapons. That is, he invested hugely on rearmament. Even the state was running on deficit financing. जबकि उनके country जो है deficit financing पे चल रहा था. Deficit financing क्या होता है? Government funding of spending by borrowing. यानी government fund देता है लेकिन कर्ज लेके, कहीं दूसरे country से कर्ज लेकर और country अपने आप को grow करता है. That is known as deficit financing. Means the country is in loss. The country is taking loan from other countries, and they are spending on their uses, like rearmament, like weapons. weapons, like spending those amount in the army. So that is known as deficit financing. यानी कि आप जो है माइनस में चल रहे हैं, नेगेटिव में चल रहे हैं, फिर भी आप अपना खर्च जो है वो वेपन्स खरीदने में कर रहे हैं. ये नहीं कि आप जो है अच्छे अच्छे काम करें कि लोगों को और भी जॉब मिल सके. सो ही वॉज जस्ट इन्वेस्टिंग अ लॉट ऑफ अमाउंट इन वॉरमेंट. हिटलर चोज द वॉर एज अ वे आउट ऑफ द अप्रोचिंग इकोनॉमिक क्राइसिस. क्योंकि हिटलर ने ये चुन लिया था, उसने सोच लिया था, ही थॉट एंड ही डिसाइडेड कि वॉर इज द ओनली वे टू कम आउट ऑफ दिस इकोनॉमिक क्राइसिस. इकोनॉमिक क्राइसिस से बाहर निकलने का एक ही तरीका उनको नजर आ रहा था, एंड दैट इज द वॉर. उनको लग रहा था कि जंग लड़ना पड़ेगा और दूसरे कंट्रीज को हराना पड़ेगा, तभी हम लोगों का इकोनॉमिक क्राइसिस जो है वो सही हो जाएगा. सो हिटलर चोज दिस वॉर एज द वे आउट ऑफ अप्रोचिंग दिस इकोनॉमिक क्राइसिस एंड विच लेड टू द फाउंडेशन ऑफ दिस सेकेंड वॉर. और जिसकी वजह से ही वो सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर जो है स्टार्ट भी हो जाता है. दैट इज
होप दैट यू हैव लाइक द वीडियो एंड वी विल मीट अगेन इन आवर नेक्स्ट वीडियो रिलीज ऑफ द ट्यूटोरियल. एंड इफ यू आर न्यू टू दिस चैनल, प्लीज सब्सक्राइब द चैनल एंड प्रेस द बेल आइकन टू गेट द इंफॉर्मेशन ऑफ द नेक्स्ट रिलीज ऑफ द ट्यूटोरियल. प्लीज शेयर इट विथ योर फ्रेंड्स and others also. Thank you for the time being. Take care. Stay at home. Bye-bye. Take care.